द कोविड-19 पैंडमिक, इट हैज़ कॉज्ड अ ग्रेट ग्लोबल हेल्थ थ्रेट टू द मैनकाइंड एंड फॉर विच देर इज़ नो स्पेसिफिक थेरेपी हैज़ बीन येट साइंटिफिकली एस्टैब्लिश्ड। वर्ल्ड वाइड मोर देन 46 मिलियन इन्फेक्शंस एंड 1.2 मिलियंस ऑफ डेथ्स रिलेटेड टू सार्स कोव टू हैज़ अकर्ड towards the end of October 2020. And latest information, 19 crores of cases and 40 lakhs of deaths worldwide. Amongst all these deaths, the major five countries who are suffering are USA, India, Brazil, Russia, and France. In this simple discussion today, we will try to figure out, based on various research articles, various meta studies have done on different topics related to COVID treatment. Especially in this particular case, we will discuss more about complementary and integrative medicine or integrative medicine interventions at the physical and the mental level during COVID crisis. Few examples of an evidence-based interventions follows like this. First one is nutritional or vitamin supplement. Second one is mind-body medicine. Third one, positive attitude of life and relationship. Fourth one is exercise. Fifth one is nature therapy. Sixth one is aromatherapy and steam. Seventh one is sleep medicine. Eighth one is botanical or phytomedicine. So this can be called as traditional medicine system of that particular area or the country. For India, Indian medical system, Ayurveda. For China, traditional Chinese medicine. Like this, various traditional medical systems. I'd like to share common risk factors for a severe COVID course of infection of COVID-19 disease. The first commonest risk factor observed is the hypertension. 48% of non-survivors and 23% of survivors had hypertension with their severe COVID infection. Second one is diabetes. 31% of non-survivors and 14% of survivors had diabetes. Coronary artery disease, CAD. 24% of non-survivors and 1% of survivors had coronary artery disease. Fourth one is COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. 7% of non-survivors and 1% of survivors had COPD issues during COVID-19 disease. Last one is renal dysfunction. So 4% of non-survivors and 1% of survivors had renal dysfunction. I'd like to share common risk factors for a severe COVID course of infection of COVID-19 disease. The first commonest risk factor observed is the hypertension. 48% of non-survivors and 23% of survivors had hypertension with their severe COVID infection. Second one is diabetes. 31% of non-survivors and 14% of survivors had diabetes. Coronary artery disease, CAD. 24% of non-survivors and 1% of survivors had coronary artery disease. Fourth one is COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. 7% of non-survivors and 1% of survivors had COPD issues during COVID-19 disease. Last one is renal dysfunction. So 4% of non-survivors and 1% of survivors had renal dysfunction. Integrative medicine practices generally emphasize a holistic, patient-centered approach to health, healthcare, and well-being, often including psycho-emotional, functional, social, and even spiritual aspects. There is a noteworthy body of integrative medicine knowledge that has evolved over the centuries, which has been used to prevent and manage varieties of diseases, and being increasingly used in the healthcare system worldwide. So it is also called as traditional medicine system, TMS. And more often it is easy and comfortable for modern medical practitioners or the conventional medical practitioners to call it as an integrative medicine. The World Health Organization, WHO, emphasizes the role of traditional medicine as a medical heritage to promote universal health coverage by integrating traditional and complementary medicine services into the healthcare services delivery and self-health care. The complex interrelationships between the immune system and a varieties of lifestyle factors such as exercise, stress reduction, healthy nutrition, spending time in the nature, positive inner attitudes, and well-being have already been demonstrated. In spite of the challenges faced by the people across the globe due to restrictive lifestyles such as social distancing and quarantine measures, the general public and patients could utilize the time of forced domestic retreat of varying degrees of strengthen the resilience through simple preventive means and self-care. By doing this statement, integrative medicine measures could be used to improve the quality of life in an extraordinary situation such as COVID-19 crisis that causes stress, fear, anxiety, depression amongst the individual and the societies of the world.